Good morning students, we are going to learn lecture 1 of unit 3, divisibility theorem and canonical decompositions, which is coming under subalgebra and number theory. Divisibility theorem and canonical decompositions, division algorithm, base B representations, then we will see prime and composite numbers, GCD, Euclidean algorithm, fundamental theorem of arithmetic, LCM, and course outcome of this unit, demonstrate accurate and efficient use of advanced algebraic techniques. Division introduction. Suppose it's your birthday. You bring 25 pieces of candy in your office to give to your co-workers, and you have 6 co-workers in your department, and you have to sit and figure how many pieces of candy each worker will receive. Now you can divide 25 by 6, you will get 2 divide 6, which is equal to 4. The remainder is 1 candy. So this can be written as 25 is equal to 6 into 4 plus 1. Now this equation actually represents something called division algorithm. We call 25 the dividend, 6 is the divisor, 4 is the quotient, and 1 is the remainder. Division algorithm is just a fancy name for organizing a division problem. We write this equation like by taking a as integer, b as positive integer. There exist unique integer q and r such that a is equal to bq plus r, where this r is greater than or equal to 0 and less than b. So this is nothing but Euclidean algorithm. Now let us talk about special cases of our division algorithm. We have a remainder equal to 0. So when r equal to 0, the equation becomes a is equal to, actually a is equal to bq plus r, r is 0. So we have to write a is equal to bq. So divisibility, if a number b divides into a number a evenly, we write a is divisible by b. For example, 8. 8 is divisible by 2. So we write 8 divides 2 is equal to 4. And 8 is not divisible by 3. How to write? 8 divides 3 is equal to 2, which is a remainder of 2. And we say we can check to see if a number A is divisible by another number B by simply performing the division and checking to see if B divides into A evenly. We see some divisibility tricks. So if a number 3 as a divisor, the dividend is a divisible by divisor if the sum of digits is divisible by 3. So when do you say a number is divisible by 3? It can be any digits. For example, 27 we take, that is a divisible by 3. So this can be checked out by adding the digits. So 2 plus 7, we get 9. That 9 is divisible by 3. So therefore, the given number 27 is also divisible by 3. If a number 4 as a divisor, the dividend is a divisible by divisor if the last 2 digits of the dividend are divisible by 4. So by example, you could understand. For example, we take the number 328. So here we should check this number is divisible by 4 or not. So in this number, take the last 2 digits 28. 28 is divisible by 2 by 4. Yes, 28 are divisible by 4. Therefore, we can tell that 328 is divisible by 4. If a number 5 as a divisor, the dividend is divisible by divisor if the last digit should end with a 0 or 5. For example, the number 30 is divisible by 5 because the last digit 30, the 0. So if you get 0, that number will be divisible by 5. So if you have a number 6 as a divisor, the dividend is divisible by divisor if the number is divisible by both 2 and 3. For example, the number 24 is divisible by 6. So this is divisible by 6 or not, we have to tell. So that means first we should check 24 is divisible by 2 or 24 is divisible by 3. If the given number is divisible by both 2 and 3, then we can tell that this 24 is divisible by 6. If you have a number 10 as the divisor, the dividend is divisible by divisor if the last digit is 0. So this is very simple. For example, 270 is divisible by 10. The last digit is 0. So it ends with 0. The number is divisible by 10. Next, we will see divisibility theory. That is statement, let A be any integer, B a positive integer, then there exist unique integers Q and R such that A is equal to B into Q plus R, where R lies between 0 and B. So we'll see some problems under division algorithm. Find the quotient Q and remainder R when 207 is divisible by 15. Second thing we want to check, minus 23 is divisible by 5. Solution, we have A is equal to BQ plus R. The condition is R should lie between 0 and B. So A value is 201. In the from the question, we are taking A is 207 and B is equal to 15. Now this can be written as A is equal to 207, B 15 and R you don't know. So we can divide manually. 207 you divide by 15, you will get 15 13 sa plus 12 the remainder you will get. So that can be placed in this equation, 13 into 15 plus 12. And this 12 lies between 0 to B. B value is 15. Yes, it lies between 0 to 15. Now we can write, they are asking the quotient and remainder. So write down from the question, from this equation, Q is equal to 13 and R is equal to 12. Second problem, here A equal to minus 23, B equal to 5. So minus 23 can be written as minus 5 into 5 plus 2. So here the remainder 2 lies between 0 to 5. Q is equal to, from this equation, we can write Q is equal to minus 5 and R is equal to 2. Next topic, base B representation definition. If n is a positive integer and b greater than equal to 2, then that n can be written as ak b power k plus ak minus 1 b power k minus 1 and so on up to a1b plus a0. So all a0, a1 up to ak are non-negative integers. And this expression we call it as a base B expression of the integer n. We write n equal to ak, ak minus 1, a1, a0 and close bracket the base b, because this equation is having with the basis b. So for example, we will take 345 base 10. So 3, the first digit 3 into base 10, 10 power. Here it is, we should start from last. Last digit is 5. So 5 into 10 power 0. Next number 4 into 10 power 1. Next number 3 into 10 power 2. Now 345 base 8, how to write? Last digit is 5 into 10 power 8 power 0, because base is 8. 4 into 8 power 1 and 3 into 8 square. On simplifying, we get the value 165. Problems. Using the base value, express, this is the equation in base 10. Here the base is 2. So now this equation we will start from last. 1 into 2 power 0, 1 into 2 power 1, 1 into the third digit is 1 into 2 square, 1 into 2 power 4, 1 into 2 power 4, 0 into this, 0 into 2 power 5, 1 into 2 power 6 and 1 into 2 power 7. Last number 2 power 8, totally 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 values are there. So power 8 you will get starting from 1 and another last 9th digit is 2 power 0. So on calculating, taking the powers and simplifying, we get the answer 351. Second problem, it was given express a 3 into A, B, O, E, base 16 in base 10. And solution, we already know, we have seen in problems, A is equal to 10 and B equal to 11 and E equal to 14. So we can write 3 into A, B, O, E. So 3 into this base 16. So we can write from E, that is E is 16 power 0, 16 power 1 here, B into 16 power 2, A into 16 power 3 and 3 into 16 power 4. Now the given A values, A, B, E values here when you substitute, take the powers, on calculation we get 240398. So this is how we have to calculate the base value. Next we will see definition of PGN hole principle. So this we have studied already. If M PGNs are assigned to N PGN holes where M greater than N, then at least two PGNs must occupy the same PGN hole. So using this theorem, we learn, we get the inclusion and exclusion principle. If S is a set, the number of elements in S is denoted by, if A, B, C are finite sets, then mod of A union B is equal to A mod A plus mod B minus modulus of A intersection B. Then modulus of A union B union C can be written as mod A plus mod B plus mod C minus modulus of A intersection B minus modulus of B intersection C minus modulus of A intersection C plus A intersection B intersection C with the three elements A, B, C. And if you have a four elements, suppose modulus of A union B union C union D is equal to modulus of A, modulus of B, modulus of C, modulus of D minus modulus of A intersection B minus modulus of B intersection C minus modulus of C intersection D minus modulus of A intersection D minus modulus of A intersection C minus modulus of B intersection D plus modulus of A intersection B intersection C plus modulus of B intersection C intersection D plus modulus of C intersection D intersection A plus modulus of A intersection B intersection D minus modulus of A intersection B intersection C intersection D. So with the four elements we have expanded, find the number of positive integers less than equal to 2776 and it is divisible by neither 4 nor 5. So we have to find out the number of positive integers less than equal to 2076. Those numbers must be divisible by neither 7 nor 5. So let us take A, x belong to N where x is less than equal to 2076 and divisible by 4. So we have to check 4 as well as 5. So we are writing for 4. And B, you can take it as x belong to N, x is less than equal to 2076 are the numbers, set of all numbers, and which is divisible by 5. Now we have two things. A is the numbers divisible by 4, A, B is numbers divisible by 5 below 2076. So modulus of A union B is equal to mod A plus mod B minus modulus of A intersection B. So modulus of A means 2076 divided by 4 plus B means 2076 divided by 5. You will get all the digits which are divisible by 5 minus A intersection B means 2076 divided by both A and B. Actually it should be 4 into 5. We have written directly 20. So this when you find out, you have to take only the quotient, don't take the remainder or don't write in points. 519 plus this when you divide by 5 we get 415 and divided by 20 we get 103. Now on calculating we get 831. Thus among the first 2076 positive integers there are 2076 minus. We have to find out the number, go to this slide, find the numbers of positive integers less than equal to 2076 and which should divisible by neither 4 or nor 5. It should not be divisible by 5 or nor 5. So we have to remove the divisibility numbers, numbers which are divisible by 5 or nor 5, 4 nor 5. So we have to take that numbers from the whole numbers. That means 2076 minus 832 numbers are divisible by 4 and 5. So those numbers when you remove from the original number, we get the remaining number which are divisible neither, which are not divisible by 5 or 4. So the integers not divisible by 4 or 5, we have 1245. So in this video, we have learned first one divisibility, second one base V representation, and third also PG and OL representation, inclusion and exclusion principle. Thank you, students.